The map, dual sight. The players, Complexity Minigun, E.G. Idra. The game, StarCraft II. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. How is that for an intro? Maybe I'll do that from now on. Maybe not. That was kind of weird. So yes, here we are, game number three here between Idra and Minigun. This time we are on dual sight, and we can see Minigun spawning in the right-hand position as our blue Protoss player, and then down over here in the left position is EG's Idra as the green Zerg player. Yes, game number three, we are tied up 1-1. Last game, we moved into a much more macro focus, and Idra doing phenomenal work and being the macro king, as he is ever so affectionately known as, managed to do a fantastic job, and his late game composition of Speedling and Fester Broodlord proved to be a bit too much for Minigun to handle. So there we go. This is once more game number three, and let's see how this ends up playing out. So far, been a pretty fantastic series. We can see Minigun will be starting off on one base play here. Now, Forge Fast Expand is possible, but not the best decision on this map. The expansion is just way too wide to be able to effectively defend early on with the cannons, and especially a strong Roach Speedling push early on from a Zerg player can really break you pretty bad. So I do expect Idra to start off with one base play. This is the same mentality as we've talked about in the past. When you're scouted first by your Protoss opponent, it is really hard to pull off that quick hatch. And given that this is just a two-player map and it is so very small, it almost necessitates going pool first. It's not impossible, but it's just difficult and can really put you in a bad position if you try to hatch first against a Protoss player who will be able to harass you by placing a pylon and possibly even placing a cannon as well. Idra, of course, moving his Overlord clear across the map, will be heading straight towards Minigun's base. And as we can see, there comes that first gateway, first assimilator coming through, and there is the pylon as well. All right, now with a little bit of dancing going on here for Minigun, he is just working his way around. Idra with the two workers will be trying to prevent this from happening, but no, looks like he doesn't manage to do so. Minigun able to get that pylon down. One of the drones will be moving across the map here for Idra to try to get some scouting information, although he is also moving out with that Overlord. He wants to try to get in there a little bit sooner and just get as much scouting as is possible. Walking by the awesome doodad there in the center of the map, that is pretty cool looking. I wonder what all that cryptic writing says. Nobody knows. Nobody really cares anyways. So pool is up right now. Still no extractor. We do have the queen coming through. First four Zerglings as well. And the drone of Idra trying to engage the probe of Minigun. No, not a real engagement. A fight. You know, they're not getting married or anything crazy like that. That would be weird. And that's even weird for me to say. I'm feeling kind of odd today, evidently. Not odd like in, I don't know, I don't even know what I'm saying. I'm just going to keep on commentating right now. So Minigun does have the second assimilator up. We'll be starting out here, of course, getting that warp gate research right away. Now let's see if he decides to go for Sentry first, or if he's going to move right into that Stalker. He can afford that Sentry pretty much immediately after that Zealot pops. Stalker's going to have to wait a little longer, and there we go, actually popping that Stalker the second that he could afford it. Zealot trying to engage the drone. The drone should be able to pull away and then move out of the base, hopefully before that Stalker comes out. Back over here, Idra does finally have the hatch coming on through. He is mining just off that one Vespine Geyser right now. Metabolic boost and nowhere in the works. Here's that second queen. We'll be dropping that creep tumor very likely, and then heading on down to that hatchery. So let's see if he managed to do just that. You gonna do that, Idra? Are you gonna do that? Yes, you are. Creep tumor again dropped down. Queen working its way back onto the natural expansion. First Zealot will be walking by this sweet-ass Zelnaga Tower that is in the form of a gateway, a red gateway, in fact, and there's actually one over here in the blue gateway. Pretty cool map. I like it for that very reason. Now, it does look like Minigun will be preparing an expansion right now. We can see just sitting on that one gateway. Twilight Council. No way he's expanding. This is some one base shenanigans here. He is just trying to make Idra think that he is expanding. But one base tomfoolery will be taking place. That Twilight Council, we could be seeing quick a Dark Templar. That is certainly quite probable. A nice force field plus this sentry action will be enough to force back these Zerglings right now. So Minigun feigning that quick expansion with that pylon placement. Idra smart enough though to realize that he should be staying around just to scout out whether or not this is actually happening. And that sentry will be taking a couple shots from the Zergling, but it should be okay. There you go, just losing some shields there. A few more Zerglings moving out for Idra to try to continue up that scouting once more. He needs to really confirm whether or not this is coming, and there it is, the Dark Shrine from Minigun, and he's also dropping the expansion at the same time. So just one gateway, there's a second gateway finally coming down, but then getting the expo as well. Very interesting here from Minigun, very interesting indeed. Now the one thing to realize is when you go the Dark Templar route, really the biggest problem early on is just not having enough Vespian. That's really all it is. You just really lack Vespian. So having those extra resources to be able to come out with this Nexus is entirely probable. Now do keep in mind, we may still see Minigun actually cancel this. This may be a fake Nexus. We expect Idra to move in with that secondary scouting information just to confirm that the Nexus has gone through. As we can see, that Dark Shrine about 3/4 of the way finished right now. So let's see how this ends up working right now. Idra back over here. Roach Warren coming out. He does have the evolution chamber, but there are no spore crawlers in play right now. And also keep in mind, there is no layer coming out. Another evolution, another extractor again dropped down there and there at the natural expansion. That Dark Shrine is now finishing. And is he going to let the Nexus go through, or will this be a canceled fake Nexus into a strong push? We'll have to wait and see. We do have a Forge coming out here as well for Minigun. Idra moving in for that secondary scouting once more, trying to confirm that this expo is up. And he will be staying here as long as possible just to make sure it goes through. And there you go. Minigun is still pushing out with those DT, but this isn't like an all-in push with, you know, trying to save those extra resources to warp in some Zealots to accompany this as well. But yes, those Dark Templar will be moving out very shortly right now. Minigun working to saturate that expansion, getting some decent saturation there as well by coming out with some additional workers, actually chrono boosting that out. Now the major question is, where are the DT? There it is, one right over there, one working in the main as well. Now we've got three Spore Crawlers coming in, and Idra just saying LOL. And the Dark Templar continuing to go to work right now. 7 kills from the DT, and Idra thrilled as always, saying, go love yourself. There you go, game number 3. No recap necessary for this game. Fast Dark Templar, 3 gate expand with a DT opening from Minigun, and Idra just really wasn't prepared. Now we saw him coming out with the Spore Crawlers. Evidently, he didn't feel like waiting for that to finish. I mean, he, in all honesty, yes, he would certainly be set behind tremendously, but he could have pulled workers off the line, and once those spores finished, you know, he could have surrounded the spores with his workers, and once they finished, he would have been actually able to take out the DT. But in all honesty, clearly Idra thought that he was taking too many losses, and he would have been so far behind that it was kind of pointless to stay in the game, and that's why he just told Minigun to go love yourself and and peaced out. Anyways, wonderful Idra mannerisms as always. Thank you guys so much. Hopefully you have enjoyed this series here between Minigun and Idra. It was a best of 3, and it looks like, of course, Minigun did come out on top. We'll be doing some more commentaries for today, so stay put, guys. Don't go too far away from your computers. As always, if you like the content, please subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. Keep watching and keep owning.